started PECO emulsification in 1988 when very few people were doing PECO emulsification, and therefore we had many problems, we had complications. Today you are in a situation where you cannot afford to have those problems, because you are in a very, very competitive situation where others are doing PECO flawlessly, and therefore you should not be get into problems. Today everybody, most of the people here are preaching the direct chop techniques and other techniques, but for the beginner still feel that the divide and conquer technique is a very good technique, and I'll go through some animations, some slides and some videos which I'll share with you. The ideal nucleotomy technique should be safe, that is least traumatic to the endothelium and with minimum chances of PC rent. It should be easy to perform and easily reproducible. Now, what are the nuclear techniques that we have? We have the divide and conquer technique, the stop and chop technique, and the direct chop technique. And today I'll be talking about the divide and conquer technique, and my technique is a combination of the four quadrant tracking technique with some features of the stop and chop technique, and therefore I call it the quadrantic cracking, chopping and stuffing technique. Firstly, the central debulking and pre-grooving of the nucleus. You can see this is an animation showing that the bulk of the energy is dissipated within the body of the nucleus, and you are far from endothelium and posterior capsule. So people saying that quadrant technique, intraoral technique is more damaging to the endothelium is not correct, because majority of the energy is dissipated inside the bulk of the nucleus, and hardly any energy is dissipated and is dissipated towards the endothelium. The first step is the sculpting technique, which debulks the central core of the nucleus and creates a trench. This is extremely important. Ensure that there is no central island. When you debulk, what happens is the central portion of the core of the nucleus, there is a hump there. And when you start cracking or chopping, you chop in the periphery, but you don't chop or crack in the center. And this is extremely important, because this island should be debulked. And there I found the Kelman tip very useful. It's an angle tip, and as you see in this animation, you have a very even posterior plate and no bump on the posterior plate. The next step is ensure that the depth of the groove is enough to facilitate cracking. Now, the depth of the groove, there was a teaching that it should be the diameter of 2 phaco tips, but what I usually take is that it should be deep enough so that you see the red reflex and are able to create crack easily. When you are trying to crack, a minimum of horizontal force should be required, and you can do it with 2 instruments like the phaco tip and a second instrument, or you can do it with cracking, it can be done with 2 instruments. Your caution is there, should be taken that the two hooks should be deep inside and not superficial, so that you can do a successful cracking. So the advantage of cracking are there is minimal stress on the zonules. Also, we must remember that for a beginner, it is easier to handle 4 small quadrants than 2 large ones, and therefore it is much easier for the beginner. Video in which the sculpting is being done. As I said, you should sculpt from the center, the periphery, or also in the central part of the nucleus. Ensure that you don't have a central island, as I showed you, because that will prevent you from cracking up to the center of the nucleus. And that's extremely essential. The cracking to the center is essential, because what we do is we crack in the periphery, but the central portion is still left. As you can see now, that almost the 4 grooves are complete, and this is the 4 quadrant. This is the last grooving up, and you see a Maltese cross at the end of the sculpting. The next step is the cracking. When you do this, as I told you, you can do it with the phaco tip or the second instrument. and there will be minimal horizontal forces are required for cracking the nucleus. And you can crack with the two hooks as I showed you also. So, and I mentioned that the advantage is the minimal stress on the zodion, and it's easier to handle four quadrants than to handle two halves. And now is the cracking. You can see we go deep into the sculpted portion. Here now what I am doing is that I am not cracking, but I am, the second quadrant is being almost chopped, because sometimes it is not so easy to crack it, and therefore it's easier to, although it's a four quadrant technique, we are making four quadrants, but we are chopping each quadrant into each half into a quadrant, as you can see, because it's easier to, you know, we go into high vacuum and hold the quadrant and chop. And now you've got these four quadrants. So as I said, it's easier to handle these four quarters than to handle two halves. And now the chopping and stuffing technique. What I do is that the quadrants are then chopped, as you can see, chopped into smaller and stuffed into the pico tip. What is the advantage? chopping and stuffing reduces the pico tip power and time, and you get clear corneas first post-operative day. And this is the four quadrants I've already made. Now each quadrant is taken up and chopped further into two and emulsified. Here you require a little less vacuum, because it's in the holding that you require, when the chopping you require more vacuum, but in the emulsification you require less vacuum. And now the fragments are being taken into nasally, because we are operating temporarily. And then again the phaco tip is introduced, and as the bag becomes more bare, you should reduce the parameters, especially reduce the vacuum and flow rate, so that you don't get the posterior capsule into your tip. And as you can see now, you are feeding the phaco, now as you can see in this, now it's been chopped again, this quadrant, and it's stuffed it into the phaco tip with the second instrument. And therefore, when you do this stuffing, the phaco power gets reduced considerably. This one sticky situation when we come across, when we are doing a quadrant technique, we have done all the quadrants, but still we cannot reach these quadrants. And this is true in a brittle sort of a cataract. And you have unsuccessful attempts to impale and hold, as you saw in this animation. You try to hold and you impale, and then you again you eat up that little part of the nucleus. And therefore, there's a risk of added damaging the capsule rectus or the posterior capsule. So what we do is we have a safer alternative. We inject OVD under the fragment, over the posterior capsule, tip up the fragment safely, and then apply the phaco tip to the posterior part of the fragment. And therefore, you're far away from the posterior capsule. And this is a situation we come across quite a few times, when it is known that you are neither here nor there, in the sense that neither is a very hard cataract nor is it a very soft cataract. It's a brittle cataract which you can't reach to. So my technique, it combines the safety of quadrant contracting cracking with the efficiency of stop and chop. It is good for most cataracts. In fact, it is even very good for hard and brown cataracts. It is safe and reproducible, and this technique is good for the beginner and the experienced. So I feel on the whole this is an excellent technique, and especially the beginner shouldn't feel, after seeing all those grand videos, shouldn't feel that he is any way less competent, and you will deliver extremely good results with this technique. Thank you so much.